I have breaking space news. In this video, I will introduce you to the crew of the Artemis II mission and the goal of their mission, and I will show you everything you need to know about the rocket who will bring humanity to Mars. Little spoiler, the rocket will have its first test flight next week. You don't want to miss other crazy space news? Then like this video and follow this account for more. However, let's start with the Artemis II crew. It happened. NASA released the crew who will fly to the moon. Artemis II is planned to launch in November 2024, and the commander is the 47-year-old Reed Wiseman from Baltimore, Maryland. The pilot is the 46-year-old Victor Glover from Pomona, California. The two mission specialists are the 44-year-old Christina Hammock from Grand Rapids, Michigan, and the 47-year-old Jeremy Hansen from Canada. Artemis II is NASA's first mission with crew aboard a foundational deep space rocket, the Space Launch System, and the Orion spacecraft. It will confirm all the spacecraft systems operate as designed with crew aboard in the actual environment of deep space. The mission will pave the way for lunar surface missions, including by the first woman and first person of color, establishing long-term lunar science and exploration capabilities, and inspire the next generation of explorers, the Artemis generation. The crew of four astronauts will lift off on the approximately 10-day mission from Launch Complex 39B at NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida, blazing beyond Earth's grasp atop the agency's Mega Moon rocket. Over the course of about 2 days, they will check out Orion's systems and perform a targeting demonstration test relatively close to Earth before then beginning the trek toward the moon. Orion's European-built service module will give the spacecraft the big push needed to break free from Earth orbit and set course for the moon. This translunar injection burn will send the astronauts on an outbound trip of about 4 days, taking them around the far side of the moon, where they will ultimately create a figure eight extending more than 370,000 kilometers from Earth. At their maximum distance, the crew will fly about 10,300 kilometers beyond the moon. During the approximate 4-day return trip, the astronauts will continue to evaluate the spacecraft systems instead of requiring propulsion on the return. This fuel-efficient trajectory harnesses the Earth-Moon gravity field, ensuring that after its trip around the far side of the moon, Orion will be pulled back naturally by Earth's gravity for the free return portion of the mission. The crew will endure the high-speed and high-temperature re-entry through Earth's atmosphere before splashing down in the Pacific Ocean off the coast of San Diego, where they will be met by a recovery team of NASA and Department of Defense personnel who will bring them back to shore. All right, that was everything about the Artemis II mission, but what about the rocket who will bring humanity to Mars? SpaceX's huge Starship vehicle could launch on its first ever orbital test flight on next Monday, if all goes according to plan. Nearly 2 years after the last high-altitude flight test of its Starship rocket, SpaceX is preparing to finally launch the Mars-bound craft into orbit. SpaceX boss Elon Musk, who hopes to one day use the rocket to colonize Mars, said this week that the Starship launch is
trending towards near the end of the third week of April.
The U.S. Federal Aviation Administration, or FAA for short, has marked April 17th as the primary launch date. There are also backup launch dates in place for April 18th to April 22nd. The FAA told a newspaper named The Independent that a decision would be made once it is satisfied that SpaceX meets all the necessary safety and regulatory requirements, with the last hurdle expected to be an environmental compliance review. So my question is, which rocket launch is your favorite? The launch of Elon Musk's Starship or the Artemis II launch? Write it in the comments, and I hope I see you all in the next video.